Now, coming up this weekend, we have one of the main events in the Brighton calendar. It's Hove, actually. I'm talking on Paddle Around the Pier, and one of the main organisers joins me now, John Owl. Nice to see you, John.
So, hi, John.
It's been going for a long time now. I can remember it in its sort of early days. What year are you up to now?
22 years. It's the 22nd year, but it's only the first year I've been so closely involved.
Yeah, and I think I first got involved probably sometime around 10, 12 years ago. And from memory, when I first arrived, it was very much a water sports-based event. But now you've got, like, food stalls, bars, you've got live music, there's stuff going on for the kids, there's a fun fair, it's all going on. So it's turned into, it's basically the world's biggest beach festival now. That's what it's been.
I think you're right. I think it is, yes. We've got 7 coloured beaches this year. We're thinking it's probably going to be the biggest paddle village ever, right from music at one end through food, stuff you can buy associated with mainly water sports. We've got a great wet beach where we've got a human diving tank, an aquarium that kids can have a go in on historic diving gear and commercial diving gear, and then the usual children's area and a great big welcome from Visit Brighton as well when they get in.
Okay, excellent. So, so if you know, if I was a tourist sort of wandering off the train and heading down to Hove Lawns, I mean, this is predominantly water sports, but it's sort of an all-inclusive festival. But you've become a registered charity now, haven't you? There's a sort of a serious message underlining the event.
Well, having seen what enjoyment of the seaside can do for kids, sometimes disabled or otherwise disadvantaged kids, we raise money to promote the healthy and safe use of the coastline. So we help people like the RNLI, some of the mainstream charities, but also some of the more smaller children's charities, particularly disabled children, who've helped a lot to get them on the beach. Sometimes, for the first time ever, they go on the beach through paddle.
Mm. And I've seen some fantastic film around that, because Paddle Around the Pier is actually on the Sunday, isn't it? That is the main event where a lot of work colleagues will get together, groups of mates, and I've seen all sorts going into the water and paddling around the pier to varying degrees of success.
Well, you're referring to paddle something unusual, which some people call it a raft race, but it's so much more than that. When there's a nearly full-size football pitch floating past, or an iceberg covered in penguins, human penguins, that is, it's a bit more than a raft race. And I think the number of entrants we got this year is more than ever. So I'm quite interested to see what's going to be on the beach on Sunday at 11 o'clock.
Have you got any personal highlights of boats that have been crafted over the years for paddle something unusual?
Well, I think the almost full-size football pitch has got to be a winner. I think that won last year. There was two teams of 7 aside, completely the referee who got thrown in when he called a penalty.
You must be delighted with the heat wave, which looks like it's going to continue.
Looks good, yeah. It's certainly better than the other extreme, yes.
Yeah. And what have you got? I mentioned that I've been there from years ago, but it's always developing, isn't it? So what have you got new this year that people need to...
Well, new this year, we're going for the Guinness Book of Records attempt on the most number of dogs on surfboards at the same time.
Oh, wow.
And that definitely is a first.
Yes.
We've got a great involvement from the kids, particularly all 3 cadet forces. We've got a design tent for the kids where they can come and try and interpret their views on ocean pollution, and we're thinking we're going to make it the world's first fully compostable festival. We've had a great help from all our suppliers, and we've got three sets of rubbish disposal, including compostable.
Okay, which is fantastic. Yeah. I mentioned the registered charity. So previously, you've supported a number of charities related to the seafront, but then now you've become a registered charity. Where will the profits be going to?
Well, all the donations on the gate, and hopefully the small profit that we make, because it's a free to enter, will be going predominantly to charities like the RNLI, and we've got applications in at the moment for the other 2 principal charities this year, and we've had a lot of applications to help people associated with our main aims, which is the health and safety use of the coastline.
Okay, and I mean, you mentioned it's a free event, but donations welcome on the door.
Substantial donations, very welcome on the door, yes. We'll have this year, you can pay in a number of ways, including text to donate, contactless payment, just read the VR scanner on the buckets, or good old-fashioned cash. We accept everything.
Lovely, John. Well, we're